Earlier, there's late shifting on Virginia Tech up front. Late shifting, I think that's why you saw the false start from Notre Dame. Usually the defensive line gives a move call right as the quarterback's in the middle of their snap count. They're trying not to let this O-line get a beat on where they're going to line up.
First and 15, Armstrong on the edge with a gain of 3 yards. Just 6 carries done for Jafar Armstrong coming in. And we mentioned earlier, the injury to Tony Jones Jr. has been the backfield workhorse so far.
And he is going to get his share of work today. He's going to carry the ball
and
have to do all the workload. He moves from a wide receiver position, so he's not a natural tailback. So it's going to be a lot of work for him carrying the football today.
Cartilage injury for Jones in the rib area. Armstrong coming back from the injury on the first drive of the season with a nice run there, yard shy of the first down as Reggie Floyd brought down the junior from Lee Summit, Missouri.
When Armstrong first went the tailback, it was more to move him around and throw the ball to him out of the backfield. Today he has to be that true tailback.
Third and one, and they will get straight ahead. And Armstrong trying to get that yard. I don't think he got there. Had to get right to the 30-yard line. This is off a touchback, so the drive started on the 20. It looks like he's going to be half yard short, maybe less. And Notre Dame's going to punt the ball away. And Bud Foster's defense getting a big stop.
Oh, hello!
Defensive coordinator, a run as long as anyone in modern college football will have as a top-notch coordinator. Foster dating back to the Frank Beamer days. We'll talk more about that as our afternoon goes on. Jake Bramlett set to kick it away for the Irish.
Thank you for getting me over!
And a run up and get it.
Hold up.
Took up four down for Grimsley. To be best field position of the day for Virginia Tech with the 43. Poor kick by Bramlett.
He actually double clutched the snap and regathered. So almost what I said, it's a cool, breezy day. And that ball side went down. And of course, me being a kid, I threw the ball around a little bit and breathed. And it slipped. So the cool is,
got to
get a sweat going. Get those hands on. If you walk out there with clammy hands, it's going to slip out.
He almost dropped the drop. So Quincy Patterson will take over in the 43 and try a deep ball that is incomplete nowhere near Frank Turner. So Justin Fuente, the head coach of Virginia Tech, this is one of the more interesting jobs. Frank Beamer, terrific run, Hall of Famer. And Fuente comes in from Memphis and takes this team over, and it's a very young team. Witness Patterson, the freshman quarterback here. The second and 10, he's going to look over the sideline for further guidance. Only 5 seniors on this roster, and almost none of them on the TV. Inside give to McLeese. So year 4, Justin Fuente inherited from Frank Beamer has a 10-win season. They win the Coastal, 9 wins the second year. Then last year, 6-7.
I like M&M's.